Students set to sit CSEC and CAPE examinations are returning to the physical classroom this week. The president of the National Parent Teachers Association wants it known that with the onset of COVID-19, teachers have had to make immense contributions. This brings new light to the fact that teachers have long been undervalued and underpaid.
We have always thought that one of the professions that should be highest paid is that profession that is responsible as the foundation nurturer of every other profession.
Alistair Thomas adds, though, the membership of the National Parent Teachers Association is wary of the return to school. Appearing on Antigua Barbuda Today, he says the authorities should have looked to the widespread, competent use of reliable technology to reach students.
During this process of COVID-19 on the online or at-home education is the question of technology. Too many of the teachers were without the adequate devices. They should have been during the time we had enough time to at least top that up to get it at least the maximum level. We didn't. Many students didn't have it.
Thomas bemoans the fact that there has not been enough widespread testing locally to adequately inform the decisions to send students back to school. He says health should come first. He adds the Ministry of Education should have heeded the advice of the Caribbean Union of Teachers before making a hasty decision. He cites the psychological issues atop the health issues associated with the return to school.
In addition to the COVID-19, are we putting them, giving them the best time to have the right psychological balance to take this exam? And what about the anxiety of the parents and the teachers?
When asked if the ascribed protocols of keeping sick children at home and performing spot temperature checks were not enough, Thomas likened the protocols to, quote, groping in the dark. For ABS News, I'm Ursula Charles Jr.